Hey everyone, it's Neil Patel, and today I'm going to teach you how to find lucrative keywords that are easy to rank for. So the first thing that you need to do is head on to over to Ubersuggest, just neilpatel.com/Ubersuggest, or technically you can just go to ubersuggest.com, and type in any keywords related to your industry. So I'm in the online marketing niche, so let's say I type in marketing. And when you type marketing and hit enter or click search, you'll end up seeing a report that breaks down the traffic overview for that term. So let's say with this term marketing, you can see here, you know, here's the search volume, the SEO difficulty, paid difficulty, cost per click, trend over time, people who write on blog posts that are popular based on social shares or backlinks or search traffic. But what I want you to first do is whatever keyword you're thinking about ranking for, type in a head term, something more generic like marketing, stock markets, whatever it may be. And what you want to do is first look for keywords that ideally have more desktop traffic than mobile. So the desktop traffic is in yellowish orange color. The mobile traffic is in reddish color. The reason I say you want more desktop searches is desktop searches tend to convert better than mobile searches. That's the first thing. You also want to look for keywords that don't just get high search volume, but also get a lot of clicks. As you can see here, if someone types in marketing, 29,000, you know, good percentage click on SEO results. Very few click on paid, but look, the majority click on nothing. So you ideally want to find keywords that have more clicks than people clicking on nothing. A good example of this is weather. So if I type in the keyword weather and I'm loading it up here, what you'll find is when people search for weather, in most cases, they are actually not clicking on anything. So look, here's weather. Most of it's mobile traffic, which is not good. And a lot of people, 62 million. So of course, percentage-wise, maybe it's a little bit better than marketing, but it also shows that marketing isn't that great. Because when you search for weather, you're looking for the weather in your area. So now let's type in another term. Let's type in digital marketing, okay? You ideally want to go after, as I mentioned, keywords that have a lot of volume, low SEO difficulty, ideally under 40, and good cost per click. The higher the number, the means more lucrative the keyword. As you can see with digital marketing, a lot more people click on the SEO results versus the no clicks. And you can also look at age range. The older the age range, the better, because if everyone's under 18, it usually means they're not gonna spend money because most of them don't have credit cards. So underneath, you'll see a section called keyword ideas. I want you to click on view all keyword ideas. This will show you all the keywords that are related towards digital marketing. Now, the way you find the most lucrative keywords to go after is you look for the ones that have good volume, high CPC, and low SEO difficulty. Typically, if the SEO difficulty is in green in color like this, that's good. So look for the high cost per click and the low SEO difficulty. So what I'll do to keep things really simple is I'll use the filters. The filters, I'll put a minimum cost per click of $1 because I want it, you know, the more the better. And I'm going to put a SEO difficulty max because I want it under this of 40 and then click apply. This will show me all the keywords that get good traffic and are easy to rank for and have a high cost per click. So when you do that, you now have a list of keywords that you should consider targeting. And not all of them will fit your website, not all of them are relevant to your business, and that's okay, but you now have a list. Now, another thing to keep in mind is the related tab. See, the suggestion tab pulls from Google Suggests, the related tab pulls from the entire database of any keyword that mentions digital marketing. So same thing here, you'll just get a bigger list of keywords. And again, you want to look for the ones that have a high cost per click and, you know, are getting searched quite a bit. Then I also want you to go to questions. This will tell you what people are typing in, what questions. Is digital marketing important? Why is digital marketing important? Future digital marketing, what is digital marketing? Prepositions, digital marketing near me. probably a money keyword. It doesn't get searched a lot, but I bet you anyone who types this in is going to convert. And comparisons, digital marketing versus traditional. This is really useful when you look at company names, MailChimp versus HubSpot. Or it could be, you know, Ubersuggest versus SEMrush, whatever it may be. So once you end up having a list of keywords that you want to target and you're going through this, all you have to do is just select the ones that are relevant for you. And literally, you can either copy them to Clipboard or just export them after you select all the ones that are relevant. That's how you go out and you find good keywords. So just a quick recap. You want to first make sure in the keyword overview section, the main head term that you're typing in has more desktop traffic than mobile. Because typically if the head term does, so does all the other terms in the space, right? The long tail variation should also have more desktop. Because if the head term does, usually the long tail variations do. If that head term isn't too hard to rank for, that usually means the long tail terms are going to be even easier. If the head term is an expensive cost per click, that usually means the long tail keywords are even more expensive. Like this is $12.33. But look, if I go to filter, or if I go here, the terms like digital marketing agency are $19.33. You see how it's much more valuable, more expensive? So when you do all of that, you have your list here. You know, you're seeing, all right, people are clicking on the SEO results. People over 18 are the majority of the searchers. And once you have, you know, a term that's not too hard of an SEO difficulty, ideally under 40, but under 50, under 60, not too bad for a head term because you're going to go after long tail terms. And good cost per click, then again, you would just go to view all keywords and then you would do the filter. Typically, you want to look for keywords that have a good CPC. You can start off with anything. It's going to vary per region, but in the United States, I usually like using a CPC of over a dollar and an SEO score max of over 40 for difficulty, because that way it'll show me all the keywords that are under that. And when you do that and you go through all the sections, just highlight all the keywords that are intriguing for you that you think are relevant to your business. And once you select them all, export them, and you're good to go. And make sure you use those keywords throughout your website, throughout your copy, and that's how you're gonna rank quicker for more lucrative terms that convert into sales or leads or conversions. So that's it. If you have any questions when you're doing your keyword research, shoot me a comment below and I'll try to answer it and help you out. If you enjoy the video, like it, share it, tell the people about it. And if you need extra help, you can always check out my agency, Neil Patel Digital. Thank you for watching.